is Norway situated?
Norway?
Yes. You heard about it?
Norway?
Norway.
Where's Norway situated?
Yeah, the country.
Norway?
I don't know.
La Norvegia. Sì. Dove stai?
Norway è in Hong Kong,
Je ne sais pas, c'est un pays au bord de la Baltique.
Allez, monsieur. Monsieur la Belgique.
Norway, the way to the north. Beautiful, peaceful, idyllic. With its high mountains, deep valleys, and wide forests, situated close by the Arctic Circle. Here the natives live, less than 2 million farmers, fishermen, and industrial workers. Some still with their typical Nordic light blonde hair. And their 2 million wives, mothers, and daughters. Altogether, about 4 million inhabitants toiling away to keep a small, unfertile country alive. These are the sad remnants of a proud and tall-walking nation which once spread fear and terror over half of Europe. A nation of warriors from the far north, the Vikings. The people who with pride could raise their beer tankards and give their mighty toast.
To Norway, home of giants!
In a ship like this, my ancestor left the wild coasts of Norway, sailed across the North Sea to Britain, raped my forefather, my foremother, I'm sorry, and founded the family of which I am a member. On behalf of the millions of Europeans who have resulted from the Vikings and their inseminating tours, I have come here to Norway today to trace my origins, to find my roots.
A lot of people ask themselves this question. What has happened to the Viking spirit? What happened to their strength, their willingness to fight, their aggression? Where is the Norwegian aggressiveness now? Perhaps they give vent to their feelings today through their odd athletic exhibitions. Elbow wrestling. Milk pail throwing. Rear-end hooking, or as the Norwegians say, ravkorup. Or the popular sport of skull bumping.
Ja, så erklærer jeg dere da for rette ekte folk å være. Ja, gratulerer.
Perhaps they keep the Viking spirit alive by putting on historical plays. In every village, town, and city, the inhabitants busily rehearse their open-air plays based on their heroic past.
Her, Norges konge! Og hva gjør du der borte? Her, i mitt rike!
Alle som vil kjøre og vet. Ja, 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 ja.
Det skal bli det siste. Du, i dette livet, jeg skal være fred i dette landet.
Ja, fred i landet, mine kommer.
Ja, ikke du da. Nå skal hestene gå ut. Her skal det slukkes.
Nå, konger, skal du få dø.
Nå og hånd skal det flyve englevinger på.
Gå ut!
In the Viking era, they were already using skis just like these. And over the centuries, the Norwegians have proved themselves able to think of little else. The part of the Norwegian cultural heritage that most definitely leads back to the Viking era is their food. Only men with the courage of a lion could face specialities like these. Some of them taste and smell as though they were prepared in the Viking era itself and left to mature over 1,000 years. This one, for example, gravlax, cured salmon. What it was cured of, we'll never know. Or this, lied codfish. Cod prepared in a special bath of washing soda. Or this, turfisk. A delicately fish-flavored baseball bat. The natives also boast of their cheeses. Bultost, Nakolost, Jaipost, and Gomolost. As hard to translate as they are to eat. But in order to eat this one, the thrifty and economical Norwegians have invented a remarkable tool, the cheese slicer. And this cheese slicer is found on every Norwegian hotel lunch table, to the traveler's delight and confusion.
This is an average Norwegian. Displeased with his home country, he suffers from a national inferiority complex deep in his heart, and one, may I say, richly deserved. But what happens when this Norwegian goes abroad, for example, to Paris?
Votre santé! Bien sûr! Oh, va! Allez, moi, celle!
Quoi, hein?
Toi!
Come on, come on, man. Bonsoir. Oh, excusez-moi. Ça, ça n'aurait que ça.
Oui, monsieur.
Oui, on va tout faire. Je parle de vert. Il est là, dans Frankrike. Il faut faire un liten kaul. Il faut aller til Norge. Har du sett de store? Ingen sted i verden som har sånne store, hvite, trestammer og bjørketammer som Norge. Og det lille røde. Nei. Hva skjer det? La meg få den.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now approaching
from
the airport
at
Oslo, Norway.
Oh, Frank,
please
fasten
your seatbelt. Thank you.
Remember, you know, we are for leading when you're in Paris, huh? But then you go to New York. I'll have for two left. Have a much feeling that you'll be there. Have you set that shoe? Du, forsiktig med den koffert, da du bare ser etter. Stopp, da du! Skal jeg forsiktig med koffert? Dette her, det altså det de nye franske tannbørstene. De kjøpte den. Du, dette her, det kondom, alt. Hva det du bryr? Alt siden den kofferten av det kjæringen min sitt. Det mørke, altså, nå jeg reist mot hele Europa. Hver eneste gang jeg kjenner den brukeren her, så skal du visitere, altså. Så her, du kan ta den over den samme. Dette flagget skal du aldri få bære på mer. Så, til Norge. Det gamle landet, her har du gått ut av resten i årevis. Og kommer du hjem, så er den tollen, tiden, treskalt. Det er kun mygg som skal få bo i dette landet her.
Velkommen til Norge, jeg er skiton.
Så, du har aldri vært ut av unionens Sverige. Jeg skal bli sånn. Farvel og takk for deg.
It's easy to discern a strong puritanical streak running through Norwegian society. Norway is one of the very few countries in the world where the advertising of any sort of alcoholic liquid or of tobacco is totally forbidden.
This is a government wine and liquor store. And this is a Norwegian tobacconist.
Psst.
Thank you.
The world-famous Norwegian playwright, Henrik... Oh, sorry, Ibsen, was born in this house in 1828, and here he grew up.
Later, he wrote many, many world-famous dramas, but not here, not even in Norway. He worked in nice countries like Italy and Germany. But his most famous play, A Doll's House, is about a housewife, Nora, who leaves her husband and her children in order to live her own life.
Farvel.
But nobody knows what happens to Nora after she leaves home. Ibsen wrote many endings.
One.
Nora?
Two.
Farvel.
Three.
Farvel.
Four. Five. Six. Seven.
Edvard Munch was a Norwegian painter of genius whose works vividly express the sorrow, the anguish, and the despair of a really bad hangover. But the question arises, how can Munch have found the inspiration for his works in a country so uncomplicated, so naive, so downright dull as Norway? Where did he find his model? Excuse me.
The trade and industry, the little you find that is always closely connected with water. They even export it. In bygone days, this was a popular cottage industry, but now it is highly developed and industrialized. The mighty and picturesque waterfalls are always a tourist's delight.
I'll put a. It takes two of these fives, doesn't it?
Yeah, that's right. Gee, that's $2.
Yeah. $2 just to see a waterfall. Okay, there we go. Oh, look at that. Isn't that fantastic? I never saw anything like that. What's this? It stopped. It stopped.
Meanwhile, the country's best salmon rivers are permanently let out for hire to degenerate British noblemen. Yeah. inventions that strike the world with wonder are Norwegian specialities. The aerosol spray can was invented by another Norwegian genius, Roger Berle, back in 1928. And this event started a new everlasting industry.
The strategic position of Norway within the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, plus the Norwegians' significant peace-loving temperament, has forced the Norwegian Ministry of Peace, until recently the Ministry of War, to adopt new and unorthodox means of defending the country.
Norway shares borders with Sweden, Finland, and the Soviet Union. The center of defense operations is in Oslo. Hey. Along the borders, there is hectic activity.
Situated outside the sanctuary where every year the Viking spirit is laid to rest on the altar of peace, the Nobel Peace Prize Institute. Each year from this building comes the message the rest of the world awaits in suspense. Who will be awarded the Peace Prize this year? Even now, the committee is in the process, go away, of reaching the final decision.
Committee has awarded the 1979 Peace Prize to Norway, home of giants.
And so the answer is given for this year. But one question remains. What has happened to the once all-conquering nation of Viking heroes? The answer? They have turned into a sly little pimple on the buttock of the world's conscience. Sneakily, they try and earn our respect and admiration with their hypocritical peace chatter. when the truth is that these boring, flat-headed Scandinavian oafs are the same gang of psychopathic killers they were 1,000 years ago. All this people... Bunch of bloodthirsty murderers! Next week, Ecuador. Good night.